Bonjour Jessica, j'espère que tu vas bien. Nous sommes le mercredi. Je ne sais pas si ça va se voir ici, mais mercredi 25 septembre. OK? So this is a summary of today's course and I try to review what we did the last time and also to add some more information. OK, so that was you taking a capture. I don't know what happened, but the video was not working. So, but anyway. So, it's here. In case we have a problem with Skype, we can still use Google Hangouts, Zoom. There are different possibilities. Okay, so with Google Hangouts, you just need my Gmail address and that's it. Quel temps fait-il? Il y a du soleil. Il fait chaud. Il y a du soleil, il fait chaud. Okay. It's hot, the it's, okay. Because we are talking about very specific weather, here we don't really have just one translation. We can have different options. Okay. Just keep in mind it's for the weather. So, quel temps fait-il? Il y a du soleil, il fait chaud. So, it's hot. In case it's cold, il fait froid. Okay, I can also add some stuff on here. Il fait froid. It's cold. Okay, just keep in mind we're using this expression only for the weather. In general, c'est means it is. So you can be confused. You're gonna see, okay, wait a minute here. You are saying il fait chaud, il fait froid. It should be c'est froid. Yeah, we can say that, but here, because we're just talking about the weather, we're going to use a very specific expression, il fait. And it's coming from the question as well. Quel temps fait-il? Il fait froid, il fait chaud. Okay, we can also say, il y a du soleil, like there is sun, or it's sunny. So, anyway, we want to talk about something else, not the weather. So we want just to say, to talk about a dish, a coffee, a tea, something hot. C'est chaud. C'est chaud. It's cold. C'est froid. So for instance, I can say, le café est chaud. Coffee is hot. Le café est trop chaud. The coffee is too hot. Le café est chaud. Le café est trop chaud. The coffee is too cold. Le café est trop froid. So basically, hot, chaud. Cold, froid. Okay? Trop chaud, trop froid. Too hot, too cold. Now I want to talk about, well, something very hot. Très chaud. The coffee is very hot. Le café est très chaud. Remember, very, très. Too, trop. Okay? Le café est trop chaud. Or, le café est très chaud en très froid. Le café est très chaud. Le café est très froid. Very, very cold. Quelle heure est-il? Il est midi 19. Sometimes the French like to use this expression. Il est midi passé. It's like past noon. Quel jour sommes-nous? On est, and you did very well. I didn't expect you to say something like that today. So this is a very good initiative. On est le 25 septembre. And we can also say, nous sommes le 25 septembre. So, but let's not forget the day of the week, le jour de la semaine. So, on est le, forgot the le, on est le mercredi 25 septembre. Never forget this article. Okay. On est, nous sommes le mercredi 25 septembre. Okay. Coming back to the last time, aimer, to like, to love. So, j'aime le café, I like coffee. It's like I like the coffee. Every time you want to conjugate a verb, you need to follow the following list of subject pronouns. Je, I, tu, you, informal, casual, il, he, elle, she, on, it's like everybody. You talk on behalf of the French, a group of people. One is, or informal. Nous, oui. Vous, you, formal. So I don't pronounce the S. Nous, vous. Il, they, masculine. Elle, they, feminine. So if I want to conjugate aimer, let's keep in mind that it's a verb starting with a vowel. So I'm not going to say je aime, no, j'aime. J'aime, and I'm going to just add the whole thing. I did it the last time, but it doesn't hurt to repeat. Tu aimes, you love, you like. Il, elle, on aime. So be careful here. Il aime, elle aime, on aime. There is a small liaison here. Nous aimons, we love. Vous aimez, ils aiment, elles aiment. You're going to notice that this kind of liaison is very important in French. It's a melodic language. So the pronunciation is very important, and sometimes the pronunciation can have a higher value as compared to some grammatical rules. So it can be a bit irrational, but the pronunciation is quite important. So j'aime, tu aimes, il aime, elle aime, on aime, nous aimons, vous aimez, ils aiment, elles aiment. Parlons de négative, I just surround the verb. Je n'aime pas. Okay? Je n'aime pas, and so forth. Tu n'aimes pas. Allons prenant de S, hein, here. Tu n'aimes pas. Il n'aime pas. Elle n'aime pas. On n'aime pas. So here it's funny because we have a lot of N's here. On n'aime pas. Nous n'aimons pas. Vous n'aimez pas. Il n'aime pas, elle n'aime pas, and so forth. Okay? Je n'aime pas, tu n'aimes pas, il n'aime pas, on n'aime pas, nous n'aimons pas, vous n'aimez pas, il n'aime pas. So I keep the same conjugated forms on here, but I add ne pas, an apostrophe, because the verb starts with a vowel. Je n'aime pas les olives, I don't like olives. I could have said I don't like the olives. No? We have to make sense in English and we have to make sense in French. A noun always has an article in front. Something. The. Something else. So, the can be masculine, le. Feminine, la. Pluriel, les. And there is an additional one. It doesn't matter if it's feminine, masculine. At least it's singular. But we have the apostrophe, l'apostrophe. And because the noun starts with a vowel or an H. Because an H in French or ignored. We don't pronounce them. They don't have any values. Some purists can say, oh yes, we do pronounce the H. I would say for the sake of simplicity, it's better to say no. Let's not pronounce them. It's fine. Je n'aime pas l'eau. I don't like water. It's, in a sense, I say I don't like the water. I don't like water. Je n'aime pas la glace à la fraise. I don't like strawberry ice cream. Je n'aime pas la glace à la fraise. Je n'aime pas le fromage, I don't like cheese. Je n'aime pas les pâtes, I don't like pasta. So here you have feminine, la glace, masculine, le fromage, pluriel, les pâtes, and l'apostrophe, l'eau. So basically we have aimer plus le laler, l'apostrophe. And if I want the negative form, je n'aime pas plus le laler, l'apostrophe, depending on the gender of the noun. So now, let's confuse you even more. Where we saw that c'est chaud, c'est froid, c'est très froid, c'est trop chaud, c'est trop froid. Well, now I'm going to say I'm cold, I'm hot. I'm cold, j'ai froid. It's like I say I have the cold. Well, I'm cold basically. I want to make sense in English. So, j'ai froid, j'ai chaud. J'ai froid, j'ai chaud. And now I want to say I am very cold, j'ai froid, but I'm adding très. J'ai très froid. Okay? I'm too hot. J'ai trop chaud. I want to say I'm very hot. J'ai très chaud. Okay? So, after we talked about, well, it's here. I'm going to just go back to Adobe. And it's basic, I think it's basic grammar book. I think it's a basic grammar book. Yeah. Because here, go back to the real page. So we have the different expressions, hein? Bonjour madame, bonjour monsieur, hein? Bonjour all day. We don't have to say good afternoon. No, we don't say that. Bonjour, bonsoir, after 5 p.m. Well, sometimes it can be after 3 p.m. So, bonjour, what is madame? Bonjour madame. Bonjour monsieur. We don't say monsieur, we say monsieur. And the pronoun, bonjour mesdames, bonjour messieurs, or simply mesdames, messieurs dames, messieurs dames. Okay. Bonjour mademoiselle. Most of the time, you're gonna, if you know the name of the girl, you're gonna say bonjour Jessica, bonjour Marie, etc. Okay. Au revoir, goodbye, bonne journée, bonne soirée, bonne nuit. Au revoir, bonne journée, bonne soirée, bonne nuit, goodbye, have a good day, have a good evening, have a good night. So, we can say au revoir or bonne journée, have a nice day, it's the same as in English. Bonne soirée, good evening, bonne nuit, good night. À bientôt, see you soon, à samedi. So now we need to review the days of the week. À lundi, à mardi, à mercredi, à jeudi, à vendredi, à samedi, à dimanche. It's like see you Monday, see you Tuesday, etc. Okay? So, we have an uppercase here, but logically we have an accent on the A. We don't want to confuse it with the verb avoir. So, à samedi, à mercredi, à ce soir, see you tonight, à demain, see you tomorrow. À la semaine prochaine, see you next week. À demain soir, see you tomorrow evening. À midi, see you at noon, at lunchtime. So let me just go back to the transcript now. Okay. So lundi, mardi, mercredi, jeudi, vendredi, samedi, dimanche. See you Tuesday, etc., etc. À ce soir, see you tonight. So let's make sure we can remember that. Yesterday is hier. Again, I don't pronounce the H. Hier. Today, aujourd'hui. Tomorrow, demain. So, hier, aujourd'hui, demain. See you tomorrow, à demain. See you next week, à la semaine prochaine. See you tomorrow morning, à demain matin. Okay? See you tomorrow morning. So, à demain matin. Demain matin, that was a mistake. Okay, I'm gonna modify it. À demain matin. Okay. So, tomorrow afternoon. Demain après-midi. I can add the A. Demain soir. Tomorrow evening. Okay. So, après-midi. Après-midi is afternoon. Afternoon. So, but I want to say à midi, see you at noon, see you at lunchtime. Okay. So, we explained everything. Hein? Sometimes we can, I'm going to go back here, it's going to be easier. So, à tout à l'heure. Ooh, what did I do? Ah no, it's not the right one. That's why. So, this is a... annoying. This is not the right one. That's what's going on. Okay, I may have to make another video. À tout à l'heure. See you later. The same day. Hein? À toutes. À toutes. For younger kids. À plus tard. See you later. À plus. It's the same. À plus. À plus. À plus tard. See you later. À la prochaine. It's à la prochaine. See you next time. ANC4, it's nice to know what it is, but you're not gonna really need it. The bees, kisses on the cheek. You're gonna mostly do that with people you know very well, they want to be fine, and that's it.